and all private schools, they may or may have nothing else, may or may not have anything else, they all claim to be English medium. So these are frantic responses to the need. They don't work. Look at them, scratch them. We call them air hostess English. Air hostess is absolutely wonderful in explaining to you emergency procedures. But ask her another question. Why did your plane become late yesterday? And she doesn't know how to answer, frame a sentence in the past tense using complex words. So that's a specific English, English for specific purposes. It has been designed in 40 hours, that is all you can teach. And that has been done successfully. But we need more than that. What are the problems? I'll give you some micro-level pictures. Let me give you some micro-level pictures, please. This boy is called Dipdesh, also called Gokul. Lives in a slum in Chennai. You know what a slum is? Slum is a place where entire village shares one toilet, one water tap, has hardly any access to clean water, where per square inch population is incredibly high. That's a slum. So this boy lives in a slum. His parents are daily wage earners. But because of aspiration, they have put him in a quote-unquote English medium school. The school charges this boy 8,000 rupees per annum plus 300 rupees per month. In that 8,000 rupees per annum, they give this boy a set of shorts, a set of shirts, a tie. I wonder why English medium schools go for tie in India. You know, someday I should ask them. If you meet them, please ask them. Okay, why do they ask for tie? It's all right in cold climates to protect their throat. But here when we sweat, yeah, both day and night, you know, why that? So this boy goes to an English medium school, ask him what your name is, ask him what is your name, and he will say, I am Divyesh. My mother's name is Tulsi. My father's name is Tangaraj. But then give him a page of the Hindu. I teach at that school sometimes. I also work with the teachers there. So one day I did this experiment. I took a page of the Hindu and I asked the boys to recognize the letters. So this boy also in class one said, this was H, this was I, this was N, this was D, this was U. I said, now put them together and tell me what it makes. He can't do that. The next, L-I-N-E. He is able to recognize, but he cannot say this is line. The point I'm making is not that those teachers are dishonest or those teachers are stupid. They are neither. They have huge numbers. 60 children in a class taught by a lady who teaches 30 hours a week, underpaid, hardly any training, husband and mother-in-law breathing at her back at her home. What do you expect of her? You know, that is Gokul Raj. Look at another child from another corner of. This girl is from my village in Bihar. When I'm there, I also teach at that school. This is Kanika. School has given her a set of uniforms. Two sets actually, two for summer, two for winter. Even that did not get votes for Nitish Kumar. How ungrateful people in Bihar can get. Okay? And if she stays in the school, she is in class 7 now. If she stays in the school another 2 years, she will get a bicycle. She is hopeful. And you know, she has already learned how to ride a bicycle. That itself is a revolution in India. As Gopal Gandhi, the grandson of Mahatma Gandhi, wrote in a book to Gandhi, how India is changing. You know, until about 50 years ago, there were hardly any girls in rural schools. I went to one of them. Today, you find them everywhere on the roads, and many of them do well. So this girl is in class 7. Her parents are also illiterate, daily wage earners.